My name is Sharon Dikobo. I gave birth to my daughter on the 27th of January in Port Harcourt. After giving birth to Tiara Lua, we discovered that she couldn't pass out poop, and also she was bringing out a greenish yellow bilious vomiting from her mouth. As a result of that, she was not able to eat. After 2 days in hospital in Port Harcourt, we were referred to Evercare Hospital. Before we arrived at the airport, the ambulance was already there waiting for us. The service was very fast, and Dr. Arua had to do an x-ray, and from there they needed her to do a surgery.
So we met baby Tiara when she was referred to us from Port Harcourt, and she came in by flight in the middle of the night, and we picked her up from the airport. When she came to the hospital, immediately we took her to the neonatal intensive care. She was diagnosed with jejunal atresia, which simply means that there is a congenital obstruction in a part of the small intestine we call the jejunum. So we offered her a minimally invasive surgery where we used a very fine instruments and went into her abdomen and corrected the obstruction.
So I managed with a team of other pediatricians and the nurses and Dr. Arua. We managed baby Tiara for intestinal atresia, a congenital intestinal obstruction. She had her surgery, but prior to then, we had some other issues like infection that we had to sort out. And after the surgery, we had to also take care of her not being able to eat, and eventually which we were able to wean off.
It was not really easy for me as a mom. I just gave birth and I'm hearing that my child has to undergo a surgery, but he told us that it's not going to be an open surgery. They're going to do a keyhole surgery. He told us the advantages of the keyhole surgery and the facilities that the hospital has, that the child can survive after the surgery. So the next day they had to examine her and everything was okay for her to go for the surgery. From there, our child started picking up. She was already getting better, but another obstruction occurred. So she had to do another surgery, which was not, when I heard of it, I kind of felt very discouraged, but Dr. Arua still encouraged me and my husband, and the help of the nurses, they made us to feel comfortable.
Sometimes these bowels, because of the sheer size of the bowel, the movement of this bowel is usually very, very abnormal. So it became apparent that we need to go and resect and remove the abnormal part of the bowel that was very dilated.
Second surgery took place on the 17th of February and it was successful. She started eating and my baby is doing very well now. She can eat, she can poop, like she tolerates feeding and everything is fine, and she's gaining on weight little by little. Because according to Dr. Arua, he always says it's not about the surgery, it's the fact that many hospitals don't have the facilities for these children to survive because they are not supposed to eat. My child did not eat for about a month because the intestines have to heal perfectly before she will start eating. But Evercare has all the facilities for the child to survive. Why waiting till she starts eating?
Tiara has spent almost 30 days on admission, and she has recovered fully. She's tolerating her feeds to the full, and she's been prepared for discharge. Now, one of the things that made this very possible is because during the time that she was not able to feed, we were able to support her nutritionally with a total parenteral nutrition, which is very required for these children. At Evercare, we boast of our capacity to offer these forms of treatment to support these babies with total parenteral nutrition. And also, we are the only hospital in West Africa to offer minimally invasive surgery for neonates as young as Tiara.
We're grateful that we have this opportunity to do this.
I'm really grateful to God and for God to use the nurses that really supported me throughout this period, and also Evercare for creating these facilities for these children that have this kind of congenital disease that is not very common.